Session today. I teach for a subsidiary of NASA. It's a lot cooler than it sounds, trust me. So we're dependent on schools and if they book. So I don't have that today, which is annoying because I am very broke. By profession, city, and a lot of them are not really looking for entry-level designers right now, which I would, I guess, describe myself as entry-level currently, but I look down on myself all the time. I don't think I'm as good as I can be or should be for a lot of these jobs, which then that gets in my way of applying for ones that I probably could get, because I overthink it, and this is how rambles go. This was requested, just a general ramble with nothing else. I'll call it like a 10-minute ramble. So, I work with a lot of bands in my area. I used to be in one myself, doing graphic design for them. So I'm working with a cool band out of New York City right now. It's called The Machinist. And I'm just finished. With the layout for their new album. This is just me trying to figure out how jewel cases work, because I've never had to. I don't like doing jewel case design, I should say. I prefer doing. Wow, thank God I was working in here, because these are just now here. I prefer doing gatefold LPs or CDs. This is another one I did recently for a New Jersey band called This Curse. So I've been doing that a lot, and so I make some money that way. But now that I'm winding down with this band, I need more bands, because this is what I like to do. I worked for a print shop. I did an internship over the summer for a print shop, and I quickly learned that I do not like the print aspect of graphic design. So what we did there was we would do the designs and then also print them and package them. Designing was not very high quality in terms of, it was designing for like local businesses really, so they already had their really crappy logos, they already had the really crappy shit that they wanted to put on a poster or a shirt, and it really just wasn't, I like designing, I like creating, and it just wasn't what I wanted to do. I was kind of offered a job there. I couldn't do it. I couldn't a lot of time. And I loved the people. I loved my boss. I loved the graphic designer who was there. It was very small. It was like three people that worked there. It was just so slow and boring, and I couldn't do it. So right now it's what I'm looking for. I'm also looking for jobs in the music industry. I mentioned I was a musician. I actually have my college degree is in music production technology, but I've been so out of, besides producing my own music, I've been so out of working in a studio that I don't remember how to do it. You know, I would love to work in a studio. I would love to be like an A2 or just the grunt that does all the work. I'd love to do that, but when you live where I live, able to afford rent or a place to live on that type of a salary, just, you can't. I live with my parents. I can't afford living anywhere else. I'm looking for jobs on the West Coast, actually. I'm on the East Coast, I'm in New York City. And just because I gotta it's too expensive. And it's so suburban, it's disgusting. You know, there's nothing to do where I live. The only plus side is it is fall, so the leaves will start turning soon. Yesterday. It's October. It shouldn't be that hot, and that today it's like 60. It's insane. So yeah, I'm just looking for jobs. And I hate looking for jobs because it's just, with my mind, it's annoying. It's just really annoying. I wish I just can get one and then go do it and then come home and do what I want to do, you know? Because having a day-to-day job, I should say, you feel guilty doing the things you like to do. You feel guilty playing video games or working on music or working on art because you're not contributing to society or you're not making money to help further advance your life. But at the same time, I know a lot of people who are jealous who don't have time to work on art or music. I feel I hate it. Like, I'd rather go do a day's work. I like to work, I should be saying. I'm one of those weird people who enjoys having a job, enjoys doing meaningless shit at the end of the day, and then coming home and being able to do what I want to do. So I do get to get stuff done in terms of art, which is nice, but it also, it's hard to give myself deadlines when I don't have a full-time job during the day. You know, when I get home, I'm like, okay, I gotta get this done by tomorrow. I work through the hours. When I don't have my job, when I'm not at my job, I spend the whole day. I'm like, all right, I have the whole day to do this. Then I end up working only like an hour or 2 or 3 hours. While the rest I'm on like YouTube or watching Netflix or Hulu. I get distracted so easily. So my life's really just been trying to find a job. So much, you have no idea how much I hate finding a job. It's the worst. What else is going on? I came out with an EP last month, September 9th. I'll link it below. It's an acoustic album, or acoustic EP, because I don't have the means to record what I would want to record, which is hard rock and rock, at my house. Some cool press. It got picked up by a blog in Australia, one of the songs, and another blog, I think, from New Jersey picked it up as well. So I can link all of that, which is really cool. I'm going to start working on another one, I guess. You got to keep going. I write a lot of music. I've written around 200 songs in the past 2 years, which is decent. I'd say 2.5 years, really. I guess we're closer to 3 now. So I'd say 200 songs in the past 3 years, which is okay. You know, I could do better. I could be working on it a lot more than I do. But sometimes you just get writer's block in terms of art as well. It gets stuck sometimes, your creativity. And that's why I want to have a job, so that I can go do something not creative for a while. Come home and be refreshed, because then I'm like, or go and see something throughout the day that triggers something creative, and then come home and create that thing. So that's kind of where I'm at. It's almost been I might go a little bit more than 10 minutes. This was a request just for rambling and stuff like that. What else was it? It's October. My last video was a sleep hypnosis video. I hope you enjoyed it. Isotones in it. So those isotones were actually the ones that I think I used 5.5 hertz as the carrier tone and 3.3 as the main one. I don't remember. I also included the tone that's supposed to simulate your body's reaction to LSD. Okay, let me explain this. my senior project, I decided to research, and I don't regret doing the senior project. I actually really enjoyed it, and it's really cool because I decided to research and create isochronic tones based off of, half of them were based off of scientific evidence in terms of what they could do to your body, how they react, and how it can help you, just by changing your brain waves. And the other five were pseudoscientific ones and like weird ones. I don't remember what they were exactly, but I had an anti-anxiety one, one for sleeping, one for migraines. And then for the ones that were more pseudoscience, I had one that was supposed to imitate what the color green would be if it had a sound. And then one for the LSD one I put under pseudoscience as well. So, and then on top of that, I had compositions as well. So I created compositions, musical compositions that went on top of the isotones. It was a lot of fun. It was weird. It was hard because the musical compositions I wanted to create in the same, I guess you would say key, musical key as the carrier tones that I was using. And for people that don't know, isotones are different than binaural tones. Binaural tones are just two different wavelengths on each ear that when played at the same time create a wave, kind of that beating, that wah-wah-wah-wah-wah in your head. While an isotone actually has the separation in the wave tone. So it's basically like someone took an eraser and just erased parts of the wavelength. And those are both going on each ear to create a middle wave. Personally, I find them more powerful and they work better than binaural. Binaurals are kind of the lower level of brainwave entrainment. Entrainment is, I think I'm saying that right. Entrainment is basically tricking your brain to go from one wavelength to whatever the wavelength of the isotone is. It's basically you can be in your alpha brain state. Used a lot in, you know, people have relaxation videos and stuff like that. It's used a lot for that. Yeah. So that's what I did for my senior project, and I put those in the video prior to that, and I think the one before that as well. And I'm pretty sure the one before that I didn't flip the audio, so it might be coming from the wrong side. But let me know if you liked that, because I would more isotones in my videos. I think they help. I think they're cool. But I do understand the, I don't know if you heard that, but an acorn fell on my roof. I also understand the importance of silence in ASMR videos. I think they help trigger the your response. One thing I probably won't be doing in the future is I kind of want to keep my channel stuck with the general. Okay, there's a lot of acorns coming down now. I don't know if you hear that, but whatever. I want to keep my channel kind of in the general ASMR category. I'm not into roleplays. I won't be doing roleplays. If I do, slap me across the face. One of the main reasons is because it's a little weird for me just sitting in front of a camera and pretending to be someone I'm not. And I just find them weird in general. I think a lot of the roleplays steer away so much from what ASMR is supposed to be, which is triggering your audio sensitory meridian response, that some of them just don't even have tingles in them. They're just like people not even whispering. They're just talking to a camera and showing you things. And then some people do them very, very well, like, what's her name? I can see her face in my head. I don't remember. She does those, like, Bramblebrook ones or whatever. I don't know. She was a witch in one. She has a lot of Halloween like role plays, which are really, really like incredibly well done. What the hell is her name? I don't remember her general name, and I'm sorry if you're watching this, you're probably not. But hers are incredible. And so if you're gonna go to that length for your role plays, hell yeah, do them. Because those are really good. They have tapping. They're perfectly produced, and it's really bothering me that I don't remember her name. This is a ramble. This is a goddamn ramble right now. Because this is me actually rambling because I'm trying to remember someone's goddamn name. Okay. We can do this. We can do this. Okay. So, while I'm pretending to not go to YouTube as I speak right now to look up her name, let's talk about Fall. Fall is awesome. And now I'm super rambling because I don't know. God damn it. I'm not gonna edit any of this shit out either. Because I am. Good night, Moon. Ha! Found it. Yeah, okay. Her videos, her roleplays are very well produced. I'm working with either a laptop camera or an iMac camera. I can't do those, so for the foreseeable future and probably forever, I'm not going to be doing roleplays. I'd rather just be tapping on stuff and scratching on stuff and finding cool things that make cool sounds so that you guys can come to my videos and have a reliable source of tingles. That's what I want, just a reliable general source of tingles for you guys. See, now this video is a little longer. I'll probably be doing a few videos in the setup I currently have. You can see some cool spooky decorations behind me. I'm playing around with or toying around with the idea of buying a pumpkin and doing a pumpkin carving thing. I just don't know how to do the audio so that it would be good. And I also hope that this video is recording the audio, because I'm gonna be very angry if it's not, because I'm using a different software on my laptop. So with that being said, if you're new, thanks for finding my channel. If you're old, thanks for sticking around. I like to leave people off with advice during every video. It's usually terrible advice, but my advice today is, if you're making brownies, take chocolate syrup and just pour it in there. Just pour it in there. Trust me. Make brownies. Take that chocolate syrup and just squeeze it in there.